Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and a very good morning to our respected lecturer, Prof. Madia Dr. Nur Adli Rizwan Shah and the audience. First and foremost, I would like to express my gratitude to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala and thank Dr. Adli for giving me an opportunity to present about Pejuang Saham Counseling for Ewin Berhad. Before I begin, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Nur Nadira binti Zahari, matric number 1182063. Okay, so first, Ewin Berhad was built in the 90s and operating in four segments, which are manufacturing, property development, property investment, and property management. As other sectors, Ewin Berhad also has its own vision and mission to accomplish. Its vision is driven by our dreams to achieve greater success, and our pursuit of success leads us to continuously strive to set high benchmarks and to reach more milestones. While its mission is to adhering the customer-centric corporate values is the heart of our business. Now, we move to the first criteria of counseling, which is current earnings. As we can see from the figure here, the chart is showing quarterly earnings for Ewin Berhad. In 2019, Ewin Berhad had its highest revenue gain of 91.7 million ringgit Malaysia. However, in 2020, the chart starting to fluctuate frequently and drop again on the fourth quarter of 2020. Nevertheless, the profit margin rose from 0.2% to 16.9% on the first quarter of 2021. This shows that the company was slightly affected by the external factors such as the pandemic of COVID-19, and it still managed to make profits and did not suffer losses at all during the global crisis. Next, for the second criteria is annual earnings growth. Referring to the chart, there has been a continuous declining in terms of profits for three consecutive years of 2019, as equal as 41.6 million ringgit Malaysia to 12.3 million ringgit Malaysia in 2020, and crashed at 4.7 million ringgit Malaysia in 2021. So it can be said that the unexpected occurrence has affected the company's profits for millions. For the third criteria, which is news and announcements. As you can see from the slide, most of the announcements are about shares buyback or SBB. SBB is the buyback of a business shares by the firm is a more flexible approach of repaying money to shareholders. Also, there is an announcement about book closure. Finally, we can consider that Ewin Berhad's announcements are positive news and is still okay for investors to invest in this company. Now, we move to supply and demand. In fact, to know whether the shares or stocks have demand or not, it depends on the volume and average volume. If the volume is bigger than average volume, it means that demand exists for the stocks and vice versa. So, from the pictures I provided in the slide, it is clearly stated that the volume is 4,008,300, while the average volume is 1,740,400, which means the volume is bigger than the average volume, so we can say that the demand for Ewin Berhad stock exists. Okay, now for the leader and laggard. From the slide, we can see that Ewin shares price is leading even though it's dropping in June. However, since the overall movement of the line graph is fluctuating and Ewin is still able to push its market price during the pandemic, therefore I believe that Ewin Berhad can push its price back and lead to bullish market. So, I assume that Ewin Berhad can be considered as a leader in the stock market. Next, for the I criteria, or stand for institutional investors. As we can see from the figure, the stock is highly correlated with PBA, WCT, AirAsia and Bauto. Also, there are 301 million total number of outstanding shares for Ewin Berhad, and 99.69% is adjusted float, while 0.31% is considered as non-institutional investors such as retailer. Since the firm has a high float, it can be said that the company's stocks are popular among the investors. Lastly, for the market directions. As we can see from the figure, the price reaches its highest between March and April, and it's fall and begin to fluctuate again. However, from the trend, we can see that the chart is fluctuating and become high again. So, we can say that the trend might swing slow for an upward trend lead to the bull market again. In a nutshell, we can see from the table provided, based on my observation and preferences, I believe that Ewin Berhad has fulfilled all of the counseling criteria, and that's it all for me. I hope you will receive some input from my explanation, and thank you for lending me your ears, and Assalamualaikum.